Mini chapter 117, Transcendence, Vengeance, and Fierce Beauty, the private screening. Climax. The storm has bottled itself back up, refusing to burst quite yet. The air feels close and charged. Lashed to the mast, Dad watches in fascinated terror as the night flickers alive across the city, from the hills on his right, arching up to frame the ocean's width ahead of him, then curving down again to his left, where the city grid runs away south along the coast. Like a play of lightning through a haze of heat, Herb's script dips at electric speed into the refinery's tanks of glyphs and pixels liberated out of Ain’tTheyFreaky, pulling out only those required to assemble Jaymi's five games in their current state. Not one glyph or pixel more than needed, nor one less. That crackling code then plays out the games in sequence. Each spirals up and out from one of the five flare stacks by the ocean and spreads in complex flame across the sky in front of Dud. Each game unfolds in the present, self-contained, and at warp speed, but dancing in such clarity that Dud can't look away. As soon as each game has coiled and convulsed up the shaft of its stack to the flare at the top, it catches a flame from the small pilot light that burns there day and night. Whenever one of the games surges out too fiercely from its stack, through the force of its unfurling, steam is injected as a coolant. Even as far away as here on Mount Lee, the hiss of the steam jets may just be heard beneath the audio of the game itself. At the start of each game's playout, the air horns in the refinery's alarm system emit their warning signal, one long and one short horn blown four times, and at the end of each game's playout, they emit their all-clear, one long blast. First, Herb's lightning script fashions a game wrapper out of black and blue pixels and wraps it around the imagination thief. This game world unfolds, told in both the first and the second person, as seen by the Jaymi Beast. It stars the Jaymi Beast, and it co-stars Evelyn, Shigim, Kim, and Scorpio in his boy drag as Angel. Next, the script fashions a game wrapper out of mauve and platinum pixels and wraps it around the platinum raven. This game world unfolds in the third person. It stars the platinum raven, Amber, and Scorpio, with a couple of walk-on appearances by the Jaymi Beast. Next, the script fashions a game wrapper out of brown and green pixels and wraps it around the host in the attic, whose concept encloses the imagination thief, as it happens, like a brown and green ring surrounding a black and blue circle. This game world unfolds in the third person. It stars the Jaymi Beast and co-stars Scorpio in the guise of Angel. Next, the script fashions a game wrapper out of apricot and blue pixels and wraps it around apricot eyes. This game world unfolds in the first person, as seen by the Jaymi Beast. It stars the Jaymi Beast and Scorpio. And finally, the script fashions a game wrapper out of blackcurrant and black pixels and wraps it around Hallucination in Hong Kong. This game world unfolds in the first person, as seen by the Jaymi Beast. It stars the Jaymi Beast and Scorpio in the guise of Angel. The refinery's alarm system sounds the all-clear once more with a single long blast. Then the landscape falls silent, as if watching Dud's tiny soggy flailing up there on the mast. He blinks while he flails. He looks confused by this private screening, even overwhelmed. His mouth hangs open, displaying a half-chewed piece of gum stuck to his lower right premolars.